Yeah, now good morning students. I'm your science teacher, myself Lalchand Prajapati. Today we are going to study the science first topic, that is the natural resources, air, water and the land. Correct? See, some questions are given here. Where do we see the bird? See, where we see the bird? Sometimes we see the bird on the tree or sometimes in the air. Or in the sky, they are flying in the sky. Where is the cow grazing? Cow is grazing on the land. Locate the trees and the roads. See trees, whether this is trees, because we are not able to see the road here, but so I think this is the road. Next, how does the river come from? How does it flow? The river come from where? River come from here. You can see here from the mountains. It flow from the upwards to downwards. Where is the aeroplane? Where aeroplane flying in the sky? Or where are the fish seen? Where we see the fish? We see fish in the pond. On what is the sailboat flowing on the? Sailboat flowing here. We can see sailboat flowing on the river. Okay, now see natural resources. We can see the something in the pictures in water. Some on the land and some in the sky, that is in the air. Thus all the things on the earth are associated with air, water and the land. Air, water and land are called the earth atmosphere, hydrosphere. Now atmosphere, hydrosphere and the lithosphere respectively. When I say where you see, we are see the some means all the living things occupy in the, and some are in the air, some on the water and some on the earth. So they are this air, water and the land are divided in three spheres. That air is nothing but that is the atmosphere. This one air, that atmosphere. The water means that is hydrosphere, and the land, that is called lithosphere. When you have to by heart, how you have to by heart means land. L means lithosphere, and we can say water. Water means hydrogen. Hydrogen contains hydrogen. So hydrosphere and the atmosphere means what? Air, consists air. Okay. Now, moreover, different living things occupy these three spheres on the earth. These living things and the parts of lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere which they occupy are together called biosphere. Means all things, the parts atmosphere, hydrosphere, lithosphere, they are comes together and they form the biosphere. These spheres have the form on the earth naturally. We have learned all these things in the previous standard. Means this, all the means spheres are formed by naturally. Means air is formed by naturally. Water also formed naturally. Land is, means that is, these all are the natural made. Means they are formed by the nature only. The atmosphere is the layer of the air that surrounds the earth. Atmosphere means this air layer. We can say our surrounding air layer is surround us is called nothing but that is the atmosphere. The surface of the earth comprises water and land, that is the hydrosphere and lithosphere of these. The hydrosphere occupies a much larger part than the lithosphere. Figure 1.2 shows the portion of land and water on the surface. Means when we see the hydrosphere and the this, what water is what? Hydrosphere and land is what? Lithosphere. Lithosphere and water and the hydrosphere are on the earth. Okay, 71% of the water occupied by the earth and the remaining 29% occupied with the land. See, we also look upon these natural component in the solid, liquid and gaseous form resources. In other words, we use fulfill our requirement. Let us now study all these component in detail. Means we can see the means on the earth we find our some component of useful things in a solid, in the some liquid and some the gaseous. We can say hydrogen, nitrogen, these are the gaseous substance. Solid means stone, all these are, and liquid means okay, so water and the like these things. See, air, water and the land are the factors important for the standing the living worlds on the earth, and the for fulfill their basic needs. They are called natural resources. Means this air, water and the land, because this, without this we are not able to survive on the land. We need all these three things. So air and water and land are, these all are nothing but they are the natural resources. Okay. ओके टू स्टूडेंट बाय।